Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy and KritaTutorials.com. In this video, I'm going to compare Krita and Photoshop head-to-head in terms of the brush performance. The reason I created this video is because a few hours ago, before I record the video, Krita version 4.2.1 was just released. And in the release note, there is one improvement or fix that caught my attention. And that is, fix possible small delays at the beginning of a stroke. This is a great news. I mean, Krita was already very performant in the last several releases. And now, Krita is supposed to be even faster because the developers managed to crush even the smallest delays in the brush engine. This is just too interesting for me to not to test it myself against Photoshop. So here is the test that I want to do. I'll be using Krita version 4.2.1 and Adobe Photoshop CC version 20.0.4. Basically, they are both the latest versions available to date when I record the video. In both Krita and Photoshop, I will use exactly the same settings for image size, which is a square 4K size, and the same brush size, which is 1000 pixels. The same brush features and the same layer composition. I even going to use exactly the same zoom factor for this test, which is 10%. For the computer specification, I'll be using Windows 10 OS, Intel i7 processor, 16GB of RAM, and NVIDIA GTX 960 for the GPU. For recording the screen, I'll be using OBS project software running in the background. Okay, so that is the setup for the testing environment. For the test itself, I will set the foreground color to black and the background color to white. Then I'm going to do a zigzagging brush stroke quickly, press X to swap the color, and do another zigzagging brush stroke again, press X again to swap the color, and so on, repeating the same process several times. I will need to do this as fast as I can, so that it gives enough performance demand and just push both software to their limits. Finally, I don't want both software fighting to get a fraction of the same system resources. Therefore, I will do the test sequentially. First, I turn off everything except Photoshop and OBS project, do the test, and then after that, for Krita, turn off everything also except Krita and OBS project and do the test again. Then after all of the testings are done, we will compare the recording videos side by side. So let's start with Photoshop first. I have no software running now except Photoshop and OBS project. Let's create a new file. To push the performance limit, let's create a square 4K image size. Set the size to 4096 pixels width by 4096 pixels height. Set the resolution to 300 pixels per inch. Make sure we are working on 8-bit per channel image. Next, make sure we have the brush tool active. You can press B for shortcut. Pick a round solid or hard edge brush tip preset. Open the brush settings panel and make sure brush smoothing is off. As you can see, when we turn off smoothing from the brush setting panel, the smoothing option up here will be turned off as well. Then change the brush size to be 1000 pixels and change the spacing to 2%. Next, I want to turn off any pen pressure controls either for the opacity or for the brush size. In Photoshop, we can go to the shape dynamic category and set the size control option in here to none. Or we can simply just turn off all shape dynamic option from here. Finally, for the brush setting, make sure the pen pressure override option up here that controls the brush size is turned off also. Next, we need to create a new transparent layer. We will be drawing on this transparent layer and not on the white background layer in here. Next, set the zoom factor to 10%. And to get the default colors, we can press D or we can click on this small button in here. I think we are good to go now. Let's just do a quick test. Oops, sorry. We need to turn the brush opacity all the way to 100%, okay? Now let's do the actual test. If I draw a quick zigzagging brushstrokes like this, notice how lag the brushstroke is. Remember, we are working in a full 4K square image size, and our brush size is 1000 pixels. The canvas only looks small because we zoomed out at 10% zoom factor. Essentially, this lag is actually expected. Now let's do the final stress test. 1, 2, 3, go! We can see how laggy Photoshop can be at this current image size and brush size. Next, let's do the exact same thing in Krita. Create a new file. Krita actually comes with a 4K image size preset, so let's just use that. Change the image resolution to 300 pixels per inch. And make sure we are working on 8-bit per channel mode, and click the Create button. Next, make sure we have the brush tool active. You can press B for a shortcut, just like in Photoshop. Pick a round hard edge brush preset. In the Tool Options Docker, we need to make sure that the brush smoothing option is set to None. Next, let's open the brush setting panel and change the size all the way to 1000 pixels. And for the spacing, we need to change this to 2%, just like how we set this up in Photoshop. For the size pen pressure control, this is already off by default, so we don't need to change anything in here. For the layer composition, we also already have two layers by default, one layer at the bottom, which consists only a solid white color, and a transparent layer on top of it. This is the layer where we will draw the brush strokes. Set the zoom factor to 10%, just how we did in Photoshop previously. Currently, I already have black as the foreground color and white as the background color. So I think we are ready to do the brush stroke test. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, go! As you guys can see, Krita does not lag at all. Even in this large image size of 4K by 4K resolution and with 1000 pixels brush size. Let's compare the two recording videos. As you can see in this side-by-side comparison, currently at version 4.2.1, Krita is actually more responsive than Photoshop. And this is just amazing. Because Krita in the old versions of it is known to be slow and laggy, especially when dealing with large size document and with large size brushes. This is the main reason why many people avoid using Krita. But since several releases, especially since version 4.2.1, Krita just opened a whole new era that turned the condition upside down. Krita is now officially more performant than Photoshop. Now, some of you who are technical geeks may argue, "Hey Widi, Krita is not more performant. It just feels more performant because it uses different brush previewing technique compared to Photoshop." Well, my answer is this. First, let me explain about the brush previewing technique in Krita. Krita uses a brush speedup mechanism that was funded back in 2015 through a Kickstarter campaign. This feature is called Instant Preview, previously known as LOD strokes or Level of Detail strokes. Essentially, all graphic software performance suffered from large image and large brush size due to the amount of data they need to process. Photoshop, GIMP, Corel Painter, Paint Tool Sai, Clip Studio Paint, etc., you name it, they all face the same problem. The larger the data, the longer it took to process it, right? Now, what the smart developer team at Krita did is that they managed to make Krita to take a smaller version of the canvas, then draw the brush feedback on that smaller canvas size almost instantly while calculates the real brush stroke in the background progressively. If you want to feel the actual performance of Krita without the instant preview feature, you can open the View menu and then turn off this option, Instant Preview Mode. Notice when I draw a quick zigzagging stroke again, just like before, we get lag also, just like Photoshop or any other graphic software at the current image resolution and at the current brush size, okay? So if this means that Krita is not more performant compared to Photoshop or to any other graphic software out there, well, technically, if you look under the hood, yes. But if you see this from the user perspective that has the instant preview mode always turned on, all the heavy calculation is done for you automatically in the background. All that you feel when drawing in Krita is just buttery, smooth performance. And that is the only thing that matters for us as an artist. We really don't care what is actually going on in the background, because that is exactly what computer supposed to do for us. Help us to do the tedious calculation so we can focus on the fun stuff, which is making art, right? So my point is this. From a user standpoint, regardless of what is going on under the hood, Krita is more performant than Photoshop, okay? So kudos to all of Krita developers for this great achievement. Okay guys, if you use other graphic software, I really like to see Krita brush performance compared against those software also using the same setups I use in this video. Please leave a comment below if you manage to test them out. Even better, if you can record those tests and publish them also as YouTube video. As always, subscribe to my channel, share the video, give a thumbs up if you like the video, and give a thumbs down if you hate the video. If you want to request a tutorial about Krita, just put that on the comment section below. Check out my other Krita tutorials at kritatutorials.com. Wassalamualaikum.